applesauce. No. I'm kidding. It says applause. Ray, do me a favor. Could you flick that once? All right. Now, remember, you're all a big part of the show, so the better you are, the better Larry is. Okay, now you see this gentleman? Now he's giving me this sign, and it says, we're on in 10 seconds, so get ready to have a good time. All right, here we go. This is exciting, isn't it?
In 5, 4, 3, 2...
Live on tape from Hollywood, The Larry Sanders Show. Tonight, join Larry and his guests, Michelle Pfeiffer, Bill Nye, the science guy, critic Roger Ebert, and me, hey now, Hank Kingsley. And now, because you've earned a special treat, Larry
so much. Thank you. What a wonderful... I'm not just saying this, but Hank, isn't this a crowd so much hotter than last night?
So much hotter than last night.
I don't know if you saw the paper today. This is absolutely true. In Colorado. How bizarre is this? In what state?
Colorado.
That is correct. They are now giving birth control pills to deer to control the deer population, which is just a huge relief to the ranger who was in charge of putting condoms on them. Doctors now report the female hormone estrogen may actually reduce heart disease in men, which is, I think, just great news, fellas, because now it means, you know, you'll live longer and it'll give you more time to enjoy those huge new breasts. Benjamin Eisenstadt, the man who invented Sweet and Low, actually recently passed away at the age of 89, and his wife... had him cremated and his remains sprinkled on half a grapefruit. We'll be right back. We've got a great show tonight.
Child Larry must have been cruelly starved for love by mom and dad. You can see the neediness on his face from the moment Larry begins what he calls a monologue, but what I call a desperate cry for love. Jesus, Tom Shales hates Larry. Oh. Man, oh man. This is great. Larry's gonna come in here, he's gonna be in a shit mood, and he's gonna throw out all my monologue jokes.
No, Ma, this is worse than the time he said Larry's face was puffy.
Beverly, tell your mother goodbye.
No, Ma, don't start crying. No, I gotta go. I am not sassing you, Ma.
Nancy, this is Arthur. Yes, I'll tell him. Everything's going to be fine. And please, don't call back for a couple of days. Thanks, sugar.
Thanks.
Listen up, everyone. I'm sure you all want to show Larry your concern and support. Concern and support makes Larry think something's wrong, so let's just act like nothing's happened. Phil?
Yes, sir.
Those are the last two words I want to hear out of your mouth.
Morning.
Good morning, Master Sanders!
Hey, great show last night, Larry.
Oh, thanks. Hey, I just thought of this. I was a swimsuit model in the I Can't Believe It's a Guy catalog. Is that funny?
It's really funny.
Yeah, great.
What did I just tell you?
What's with them?
They read the reviews.
You can see the neediness on his face from the moment Larry begins what he calls a monologue.
Wow.
But what I call a desperate cry for love.
Wow. Read it again.
I'm telling you, Hank, your name's not in it.
I know. I dodged a bullet. I'm just wondering what the hell I'm going to say to Larry. Huh? I mean, I have to choose my words very carefully. Come on, read it again.
You've gotten thousands of wonderful reviews every night. The studio is filled with people that love you. Not to mention 18.2 million adoring fans watching at home.
Fucking.
They can be fucking with anyone in the background, but they chose Larry.
There's something wrong with you.
Maybe.
Just because I'm famous, I gotta take this kind of crap, and then I can't do anything. At least if I was a regular guy, I walked into a bar and some guy says you're puffy and there's neediness written all over your face, I can take him outside.
And do what?
And I am speaking hypothetically.
I just want to tell you how sorry I am. Gee, it was just awful. I mean, it was so unfair. Yeah, I mean, that review, should you know, hurt me as much as it hurt you.
Really?
Well, even though my name wasn't mentioned.
You like the new curtain?
Are you kidding me? My God, of course I love the new... I mean,
you know, there is no new curtain.
Wonderful crowd. Let's have a great show, okay?
Yeah, plan.
And remember the lesson taught by the great Johnny Rivers.
Right. Don't do a TV movie with your daughter.
No.
Don't sell jewelry.
No.
Don't go on E.
No. Don't get caught up with the press and what they write about you.
Got it. But I can sell jewelry.
Yeah,
right?
Put me down for a charm bracelet.
Open
go get her. A tiger.
Just kissing up to you. Let me tell you something. You are so much hotter than last night's crowd. What was wrong with last night's crowd? Where did they come in from? Whew. You know, John Kennedy Jr., recently married, he said in a magazine interview, "Hey, that's no reason to remove me from the most eligible bachelor list." Actor Robert Downey Jr. is in a detox center, still trying to shake his drug problem. He claims that he was just doing research for his starring role in his next big film, The Robert Downey Jr. Story. I guess a lot of you may have seen, did you see the newspaper today? There was a little thing in there. There was a little review of the Larry Sanders Show written by Tom Shales. Actually, I believe it was the Recycler. I believe that's what he writes for now. You know, Tom Shales said in his review that I remind him of a needy talk show host. Tom, this is a needy talk show host, pal. This is a needy talk show host. We'll be right back. No flipping. No flipping.
The Larry Sanders-Tom Shales feud heated up last night when Sanders ridiculed critic Tom Shales in his monologue. Mm. Shales fired back this morning by saying, "I don't mind that he made a joke about me. I just wish it was funny."
Jesus! Jeez! What's going on?
I'm sorry I was gone so long.
How's your stomach?
It's still moving south toward the border. Sting sounds great, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's been playing that song the whole day, and I swear to God, it's making me sick. Could you please tell him to keep it down? Is that asking too much?
You know, this thing is eating you up. Sweetie, I beg you not to respond, didn't I? You've taken a review that would have died a natural death, and you've turned it into a big story.
What is that song?
The song? It's King of Pain.
He's an asshole. He knows. He read it.
Oh, you broke your favorite cup. Why did you do that?
Because it's Hank's.
Oh, Larry. No, I really don't think you want to send this.
Just fax it.
Bruce, I'm sorry, but would you excuse us just for a second?
What is wrong?
You want me to send this to Tom Shales?
Yes.
Dear dumb fuck.
Keep going.
Larry, I am sorry, but I can't send this.
Fine, then I'll fax it myself.
Oh, you don't even know how to use the fax machine,
remember?
Oh, really?
I'll turn it on, stick it in, and just hope for the best. It'll be like sex.
Hi, Larry.
Oh, hey, Sting. Hey, buddy. How you doing?
Good
to have you here. Listen, I was just wondering, could you do a different song besides The King of Pain?
Larry, I've been rehearsing King of Pain all day.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh. Well, I was hoping you could do something from your new album. Something a little fresher.
Larry, you asked for King of Pain.
Who's that about?
King of Pain?
Yeah.
Well, I thought it was about me, but maybe it's about you.
Okay. See you out there, huh?
Sure.
Dear dumb fuck, who are you to sit on your fucking ass while I'm out there working my ass off trying to entertain America, you boring, yellow-bellied, talentless dickhead? You just sit there watching me, hoping the world doesn't find out what a fucking fraud you are. Sincerely, Larry, suck my cock, Sanders.
Have you met David?
No, hi.
Oh my gosh, this is a real pleasure. Brian has told me all about you. And
who is that?
It's David, you know.
Oh, hi. Hi, Hank Kingsley.
Hi.
I want you to go down to the first floor and I want you to get some boxes.
Why?
Because I'm quitting.
What?
Yeah.
What for?
Because I'm not going to be treated like this by Larry anymore. So do what I tell you.
Hank, I don't know what this is all about, but why don't you just try talking to Larry? Look what communication did for me and David.
Listen, that may work in your little gay paradise, but this is my life, okay? Hey, very nice meeting you. Now wrap up the social hour and get the boxes.
At that time, they probably wanted you to do all that television so that you would get more well-known and get higher ratings.
Right.
Which show were you doing at the time?
The Flying Nun.
Oh, you were so good on The Flying Nun. Seriously. Believe that all the current religious comedies are derivative from that. If it hadn't been for the flying nun, I swear to God that I don't believe the 700 Club would be on today. Isn't she a joy, Hank?
Everyone is a joy.
Yeah. My next guest, you're going to love this guy. He's a very funny comedian, and I want you folks to really give him a warm welcome. It's his first time on the show. I'm a big fan of his, and he's worked all the clubs, and we're lucky to have him. Jake Johansson. Give Jake a hand.
Thanks very much. Always nice to be here. I'm a little upset. I just got $1,000... electric bill. That's high, right? Thousand, obviously a mistake.
So was I right?
I called.
Oh yeah, you were great.
Was I really?
You were really great.
Really?
Oh yeah.
You were terrific. You were really funny, and I was relaxed almost.
Well, you were great.
So she says, "Well, how many refrigerators do you have?" Like that could possibly be the answer. So I said, 100. I have 100 refrigerators. How about that? I have 100 refrigerators, and they're all open. That's how I cool my house. I have a... 100 open refrigerators. And then if it gets too cold, I start turning on blow dryers.
I wasn't good tonight.
Really?
Yeah. Don't you think?
No, I thought you were terrific.
Isn't it odd how we still need to hear approval we do?
Oh, always. Are you kidding? I mean, I'll go home tonight and wake up my 9-year-old son and ask him what he thought. I rely on his opinion. He's smart.
Tom Shales is such a jerk.
Who?
Tom Shales is a television critic.
I don't do television anymore.
It'd be a breach of security for them to know each other. You know, you think you're getting some expert when you push all those buttons on the voicemail. Really, you're just ringing phones at random in their giant until someone walks by and, you know, hello? Well, how many refrigerators do you have? You know? Thank you very much.
Hilarious. We'll be right back. No flipping.
You having fun?
Yeah.
Good.
I really like him.
Well, I'd be careful.
Why?
Well, you sit next to someone for 8 years and you think you know them, but you don't.
He says in this review that there's neediness written all over my face.
Well, I thought he said that your face was puffy.
Yeah, he said that too. He said my face is puffy. What if he's right? What if he's right about all
of it? Well, so what? What if he is? I mean, so what if you're needy? Who isn't needy? The whole world is needy. At least you have the guts to get out there in front of millions of people and be needy.
Let me see it. Dear Larry, Tom Shales is my favorite writer. Sincerely, Hank, blow me Kingsley. It's got to be a hoax from Phil.
Well, there's nothing funny about it.
Another indication is Phil.
No, Artie, this is Hank's handwriting.
Where is he?
In his office.
Do you want to go to dinner?
Now?
Yeah. Well, not now, but maybe right after this.
Oh, sure.
Okay.
All packed up and ready to go.
Yes, I am.
Good move. So this was your little inter-office communique, huh?
You bet it is.
Why?
Why? Because Larry sent me this vile, filthy fax. It's not only immature, it is disgusting. I mean, look at the language.
This wasn't meant for you. This is for Tom Shales.
Oh, yeah? Then what's it doing in my fax machine?
I have no earthly idea.
Okay. Why does it start, dear dumb fuck?
I can understand your confusion. But this fax was meant for Tom Shales, the critic, the guy that wrote the review.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, what am I going to do?
I don't know.
What possessed you?
I don't know. Well, I'll tell you what possessed me. I wanted to own the moment. And first time I won the Oscar, I was so scared. It was
right.
Like out-of-body experience. I don't remember anything that happened. I might as well not have been there.
I can imagine.
Second one, I wanted to own it. So I said what I felt. That's what I felt. Was that sickening?
Tom Shales just walked in. Who? He's just walked in. That...
Here? I thought you said he worked for the Washington Post.
Yeah, he's here doing politically incorrect that.
I did that show. Bill Maher hit on me.
Excuse me.
Hi, Tom.
Well, hi, Larry.
How you doing?
Just fine.
Listen, I just want you to know something, Tom. I don't have problems taking criticism. I think you know that about me. But I think when you attack, my personal life and stuff about me being needy and not getting enough love from my parents, I don't think that's right. I think that's over the line.
How come you never have me on your show, Larry? You've had other critics. You've had Gene Siskel, that big fat Roger Ebert, Gene Shalit, Rex Reed.
Yeah.
Never me.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Tom, and I'm sorry I sent you that fax. Honestly, that was just I got a little carried away. I think I misunderstood the whole thing.
I didn't get any fax.
Busy?
What?
Did Artie tell you? I got Tom Sale's fax by mistake.
Yeah, he told me. I'm really sorry.
It's good because I found out how much pain you were in. So, I forwarded your fax to that asshole this morning.
Hank?
Yeah?
Let me see if I have this right. You sent Tom Shales the fax that starts out, "Dear dumb fuck."
Yes, I did.
You dumb fuck.